ways for her engagement on Wednesday. The Duchess of Cambridge looked typically chic in a recycled Oscar de la Renta suit as she paid a visit to the Royal Opera House in London this morning. Kate, 37, at the costume department of the Royal Opera House to learn more about their use of textiles, commissioning of fabrics and supply chain. While there she was treated to a private performance of the romantic ballet The Two Pigeons. Kate appeared completely entranced by the dance and following the performance a giggling Kate could be seen chatting with the two dancers, and sharing a joke. She wore a stylish peplum two-piece by Oscar de la Renta costing £2,736 that she was last spotted wearing for a mental health conference in February 2017. Her choice in purple comes just 2 days after Meghan wore the same shade during her visit to Birkenhead. Keeping out the January chill, Kate ditched her normally nude stockings for a pair of black opaque tights and appeared to have invested in a new pair of heels. The mother of three, who is well known for recycling her footwear, in particular a pair of giant Vito Rossi nude pumps, she pipped for a pair of black stilettos with a gold buckle detailing by Rupert Sanderson costing £525 today. Kate appears keen to refresh her shoe collection with her visit today coming just a day after she showcased a new pair of C by Chloe walking boots costing £360 on Tuesday. Adding another designer to her arsenal, Kate could be seen carrying a small black leather handbag costing £495 by Aspinall of London. She completed her look with a pair of 18K gold Asprey London oak leaf hoop earrings, a pair that she has favored on several occasions, costing £5,000. January is normally a quieter month in the royal calendar. But today sees three duchesses out on duty. Later Meghan will visit the Mayhew Animal Shelter in North London, followed by a trip to a charity performance of Cirque du Soleil with her husband, Prince Harry, at the Royal Albert Hall this evening. And in Scotland Camilla will undertake two engagements at the University of Aberdeen in her role as Chancellor. Kate's visit allowed the royal to find out more about the scale of the department's work and how different textiles influence various costumes. After being a quick tour of the historic building in London's Covent Garden, Kate was taken to the costume department where she met with the seamstresses responsible for the costumes we see on stage. Stockroom supervisor Morag Beaton was on hand to show Kate how tutus are made, surely of interest to the mother whose daughter Charlotte is thought to be taking weekly ballet lessons. The Duchess then met with Royal Ballet principal dancers Lauren Cuthbertson, Laura Moreira and Vadim Mundegrove, who will explain how various factors such as lighting, interaction and movement influence the designs of their costumes. The textile and manufacturing industry is of enormous interest to Kate as her paternal great-great-grandfather, Francis Martineau Lupton, was a mill owner who ran the family's successful textile manufacturing business, William Lupton & Company, with his three brothers. The Royal Opera House Costume Department is responsible for creating, refurbishing and conserving thousands of opera and ballet costumes per season, with up to 600 costumes per production. Up to 10,000 costumes are used each year by artists from the Royal Ballet and the Royal Opera House. The department has built up a historic costume collection of more than 5,000 items, including some dating back to 1861. Many of the costumes are used time and time again thanks to good maintenance and repair. It takes the entire revival workroom around 1,500 hours to refurbish the costumes. During her visit to the costume department, Her Royal Highness will visit the pattern room where she will be shown the process of working and creating costumes for a new production with designers, including sourcing fabrics and samples. She will then visit the dye shop where staff will showcase different techniques including dyeing, hand painting, staining garments and digital printing, which allows the team to reproduce historic fabrics no longer available. Kate will also meet costumers in the workroom working on multiple new shows. This is Kate's second engagement of 2019, having returned to work on Monday with a visit to a community garden in Islington. She joined schoolchildren at King Henry's Walk Garden in North London to see how the project brings people together through gardening and food growing. The garden has been run for more than a decade by community volunteers with support from Islington Council. It contains allotments and a firm plot to plate area for children, which enables them to grow ingredients to put on their own pizzas.